Happy Birthday, Mayoka. How about Jeff Ryan on saxophone tonight? Yeah. This song I recorded with the late great Grover Washington Jr. Imagine that, a poor boy from England. We recorded it very late night, called it Midnight in Manhattan. I just met Jeff today. Isn't that amazing? The musicians can get together and play music. I just met in some far off land. There's a lot of great people I've met along the way in this journey that I call the music business. I've been in for 45 years now. I haven't had a real job in 45 years. I'm not boasting, I don't recommend it. But it worked out for me, and one of the people I met, Paul McCartney once. Wow. For 2 minutes. 2 minutes of my life with Paul McCartney. I met Freddie Mercury. He just looked at me like, who are you? Which is all I deserved at that time, being 20 years old. I met a great bass player who was also a great basketball player, Wayman Tisco. We all know Wayman, we all played with him. He was a big, wonderful guy, just big, big smile, big personality, just big. I heard the news that he passed away right when I was recording this next song, so I dedicated the song to him, which I called Bright, because it reminds me so much of him. It's for Wayman.
Wayman. Way back in the 90s, the early 90s, I started playing a club. This is when I first started as a solo artist. I played a club called the Caravan of Dreams in Fort Worth, Texas. And while I was there, I got an idea for a song. And I decided to call it Caravan of Dreams. Once again, Jeff Ryan. And I also have Ollie Silk on the keyboard. Hello, Ollie. Jeff is playing his own show tomorrow at 11 o'clock. Don't be up all night drinking. We haven't played any old songs. Usually I start my show and just play all old songs. And we've left it till now. Do you remember the Young Rascals? No. They used to be young. This is the 60s. Anyone remember the 60s?
Yes.
I lived the 60s, okay. Wesley Joseph on the drums there, ladies and gentlemen. Wesley. We're going to play a song for you. If you remember the song at all, I want you to sing along. But wait till I tell you, okay? I'll give you the signal. Thank you. 45 years, I should be slowing down, I should be retiring, I should be playing at the pub on weekends, and instead I'm out here playing with the best musicians in the world. I love it. Okay, let's go back and just stay in the old school. That's what they say in America. Old school. You like that old school music? They don't write songs like that anymore. It's not just me, is it? I mean, they don't write songs today like... Say a little prayer. I'll tell you a story. It's hard to talk and play at the same time, guys. Tell you why it's hard to talk and play at the same time, because you're playing in one rhythm and you're talking in a different rhythm. Unless you talk like this, and then it becomes very easy because you're always talking on the beat. But nobody talks like that. One day I was pretty particularly sad. This is when I was a teenager, and I heard the song on my transistor radio, which kind of stayed with me all this time. This has become one of my favorite songs. And do you remember those transistor radios? I'm talking to the older people now. those little transistor radios, one dial and one earpiece, one. Because back then we only had one ear. And I was particularly sad that day because my younger brother Danny had set fire to our bedroom. And I had a new electric guitar which I was very proud of. And that was burnt to a crisp. It was burnt like charcoal. You know what charcoal looks like. I can still smell it. But I should thank Danny because I was forced to go back to playing my acoustic guitar, which is the same kind of guitar as I play today. So thank you, Danny. And I took my bicycle, I went out to the park with my little transistor radio, and I heard this song, which I'm sure I heard this song before, but that day, in my grief, that song actually reached me in a way that no song's ever reached me. It was like the lady that was singing was saying a prayer just for me, and that was Aretha Franklin. That's still one of my favourite songs of all time. Written by Burt Bacharach and Hal David. A few years later, I turned on my radio. This is a different radio, much bigger radio. It's called a wireless. We call it a wireless in England. It had one big elliptical speaker. Do they still make elliptical speakers? This is the song I heard. This is the Isley Brothers now. Thank you. Where's Dave Vitale? Come on, Dave. Dave Vitale, he has a wah wah too. He's going to join us.
You know what my mama said? Come on.
Joseph on the trumpet. Thank you. song will end up descending to some rock and roll jam at the end, so watch out. So head over heels.
Thank you.
Other form of right way on the bass, Dave Hightower. Dave Eitel, I just saw Dave today for the first time in 20 years, and I asked him if he remembers where I saw him last, and it was actually right outside the Shepherd's Bush Empire in London, on the night that we played a ridiculous midnight show in 1999. And some of you were here, I'm sure that were there, at least one person. Yes. I think it was... Robbie Vincent said to me, "Let's do Midnight Show." I said, "You're crazy." And we did it. And Dave Eitel played that show with me. Anyway. I met a singer called Al Stewart when I was 20 years old, and it changed my life. We wrote this song together. Time Passages. Of course, Sir Paul McCartney, who wrote that song, and I met him once, and you know, I wanted to tell him how much he influenced me, and probably the reason that I play the guitar is because of the Beatles. Back then, when I first heard. Greatest sound in the world. I want to play like that. And maybe one day the girls will scream at me. Thank you once again, you made my dreams come true. But that's the first Beatles song I ever recorded, and that's on my latest CD, which is Groovin', which we have a few out there, I know. And, we're going to play a song I wrote when I woke up one morning in San Diego, California. And I decided to call the song San Diego. We'll be right back. Thank you so much. Once again, Jeff Ryan. to Christian for bringing me here. Thank you.